जनवल्लभ गिरिवरधारी यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन जमुना तिरावन चारी जमुना तिरावन चारी जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी जय गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन जमुना तीरावन चारी जमुना तीरावन चारी हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Nikai Gaur Hari Bol Hari Bol Hari Bol Nitai Gaur Hari Bol Jaya Jaya Prabhupada 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 Jaya Prabhupada जय हो विष्णु पाद परभंस प्रवर्जाचार्य अष्टोत्तर श्री श्रीमद अभय चरणारविंद भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय हो विष्णु पाद परमहंस प्रवर्जाचार्य अष्टोत्तर श्री श्रीमद भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती ठाकुर गोस्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद की संवेद भक्त वृंद की गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपा कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदांतिकं वंदेहं श्रीगुरु श्रीयुता पदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातान् सहगना रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं सावद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजना सहितं कृष्ण चैतन्य देवं श्री राधा कृष्ण पादान सहगना ललिता श्री विशाखान्वितांश्च हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगत्पते गोपेशा गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये वांछा कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवतम फर्स्ट कैंटो फर्स्ट चैप्टर टेक्स्ट नंबर 3। निगमगल्पतरोरगलितं फलं सुखमुखाद् अमृतं द्रवसंयुतं पिबत भागवतं रसमालयं मुहुरहो रसिका भुवि भावुकाः। निगमकल्पतरोरगलितं फलं सुखमुखाद् अमृतद्रवसंयुतं पिबत भागवतं रसमालयं मुहुरहो रसिका भुवि भावुकाः। निगमकल्पतरोरगलितं फलं सुखमुखाद् अमृतद्रवसंयुतं पिबत भागवतं रसमालयं मुहुरहो रसिका भुवि भावुकाः। निगमकल्पतरोरगलितं फलं सुखमुखादमृतद्रवसंयुतं पिबत भागवतं रसमालयं मुहुरहो रसिका भुवि भावुकाः। निगमगल्पतरोरगलितं फलं निगमखादमृतं द्रवसंयुतं विगत भागवतं रसमालयं मुहुरहो रसिका भुवि भावुकाः। माताजी निगमकल्पतरोरगलितं फलं सुखमुखादमृतद्रवसंयुतं पिबत भागवतं रसमालयं मुहुरहो रसिका भुवि भावुकाः। वट वर्ड मीनिंग निगम द वैदिक लिटरेचर्स, कल्पतरोह द डिजायर ट्री, गलितम फुली मैच्योर्ड, फलम फ्रूट, सुख श्रील सुखदेव गोस्वामी द ओरिजिनल स्पीकर ऑफ श्रीमद् भागवतम, मुखात फ्रॉम द लिप्स ऑफ अमृत नेक्टर द्रव सेमी सॉलिड एंड सॉफ्ट सेमी सॉलिड एंड सॉफ्ट एंड देयर फॉर इजिली स्वॉलेबल संयुतम परफेक्ट इन ऑल रिस्पेक्ट्स पी बता डू रिलीज इट भागवतम द बुक डीलिंग इन द साइंस ऑफ द इटर्नल रियलाइजेशन विद द लॉर्ड रसम जूस दैट विच इज रिलीजेबल आलयम अंटिल लिबरेशन और इवन इन ए लिबरेटेड कंडीशन मुहु ऑलवेज अहो ओ रसिका Those who are full in the knowledge of mellows, Bhuvi on the earth, Bhavukah, expert and thoughtful. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Translation. O expert and thoughtful man, release Srimad Bhagavatam, the mature fruit of the desired tree of Vedic literatures. It emanated from the lips of Sri Sukadeva Goswami. Therefore, this fruit has become even more tasteful. Although its nectarian juice was already releasable for all, including liberated souls. Purport, we are continuing from the previous speakers. So, in this sloka, it is definitely stated that a spiritual rasa, which is released even in the liberated stage, can be experienced in the literature of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
due to its being the ripened fruit of all Vedic knowledge. By submissively hearing this transcendental literature, one can attain the full pleasure of his heart's desire. But one must be very careful to hear the message from the right source. Srimad Bhagavatam is exactly received from the right source. It was brought by Narad Muni from the spiritual world and given to his disciple Sri Vyasadeva. The later in turn delivered the message to his son Srila Sukadeva Goswami. And Srila Sukadeva Goswami delivered the message to Maharaj Parikshit just 7 days before the king's death. Srila Sukadeva Goswami was a liberated soul from his very birth. He was liberated even in the womb of his mother, and he did not undergo any sort of spiritual training after his birth. At birth, no one is qualified, neither in the mundane nor in the spiritual sense. But Sri Sukadeva Goswami, due to his being a perfectly liberated soul, did not have to undergo an evolutionary process for spiritual realization. Yet, despite his being a completely liberated person situated in the transcendental position above the three material modes, he was attracted to this transcendental rasa of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is adored by liberated souls who sing Vedic hymns. The Supreme Lord's pastimes are more attractive to liberated souls than to mundane people. He is of necessity, not impersonal, because it is only possible to carry on transcendental rasa with a person. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, the transcendental pastimes of the Lord are narrated, and the narration is systematically depicted by Srila Sukadeva Goswami. Thus, the subject matter is appealing to all classes of persons, including those who seek liberation and those who seek to become one with the Supreme Whole. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. So we are in Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto, first chapter, verse number 3. Before speaking, I want the blessings of all the Vaishnavas so that I can speak something which can be releasable to all of you. Rasamalayam. And for my purification. So here in this verse, Prabhupada is talking about a spiritual rasa, which is released even in the liberated stage. And this Srimad Bhagavatam is called Rasamalayam. So here all the rasas are present. In other different literatures of Vedic literatures, there are different rasas mentioned, but not the all rasas are mentioned in all the Vedic literature. This Srimad Bhagavatam contains all the different rasas which are there, all the mellows are there, which all are discussed here. One devotee was telling that, like in a combined family, when you see that so many relatives are there, uncle is there, bua is there, mausi is there, all so many families, and even in the village, if the village is known to a very close, normally earlier what used to happen that in village, people used to know each other very thoroughly and very nicely. If anyone enters into the village, everyone will ask, who is this person, where he is going. So no one is unnoticed there, not like a city where who is coming, your next door, you don't know. Or you don't need to know the situation like that. But in villages, the situation is not like that. Once, one of my friend was saying that he went to one village, and in one of the villages in Bihar, so he said that when he went there to meet one of his friend, and just for remaining there 2-3 days, whole village was knowing him. And when he was leaving the village, almost 50-100 people came out of the village to see him off. So it was like a reception, and someone was saying, oh, you are his friend, so you are friend of us also. So everyone was relating with him. So this is the culture of village, where you know each other very nicely. And right now, this thing is also deteriorating in villages also, but this is a situation of 30 years back, what used to happen, and some places it is still remaining. So in combined family, you see all varieties of person, relatives are there. So the rasa, you can relate with each other, all the rasas will be present. It is not that only one brother or only one son is there, no sister, so you can't relate, or he don't know what is the having a cordial relationship with sister or other brothers. So that is not available. But this Srimad Bhagavatam, being the fountainhead of all incarnations, Sri Krishna is present along with other incarnations, details are given. So Krishna, as Brahmaji prays, that Adi Purusha, Ishvara Parama Krishna, Sachidananda Vigraha, Anadir Adir Govinda Sarva Karanam. Since he is the fountainhead of all the incarnations of Vishnu Tattva, he is also the reservoir of all the mellows. All mellows are present in the pastimes of Krishna. And so this rasa is here, is experienced, and this and it can be experienced in the this literature of Srimad Bhagavatam. Prabhupada is writing this due to its being the ripened fruit of all Vedic literature. Sukumar Krishna Prabhu was saying that, once I was talking with him, so he was saying that people, why it is written, one of the analogy that this Srimad Bhagavatam is a ripened fruit, that in Srimad, in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Yam Mimam Puspitam Vacham Pravadantya Vipaschita Vedavat Ratah Partha Nanyad Astiti Vadina. Persons who are attached to the fruitive results of the Vedas, they say there is nothing higher. They are attracted by the flowery language of the Vedas. In the tree, there is flower, then there is fruit, then this, gradually that fruit is in the mature state, then it is completely ripened. So this Srimad Bhagavatam is completely ripened fruit. But people who are just attracted by the flowery language of the Vedas, they say that there is nothing higher. They are just attracted by the flower, and they leave the ripened fruit, which will come later on. But this Srimad Bhagavatam is the ripened fruit of all the Vedic literatures. Kamat manah swargapara janma karma phala pradam kriya vesha bahulam bhogar aishwarya gatim pradam. So these persons are attached to their sense gratification. That's why they don't go further. They are just attached to the flowery languages of the Veda or the flowers of the Vedic tree. And the fruit of that Vedic tree is Srimad Bhagavatam. And that fruit is also not simply just taror gavlitam phalam. And it is said that this fruit is such that there is nothing to leave. Isme koi, there is no seed, no gutli. You can't chew and throw. You just, from whichever side you want to release it, it is releasable. So, but why then sadhaka is not able to release it? Although the holy name, character, pastime and activities of Krishna are all transcendentally sweet like sugar candy, but due to our being in a diseased state, we are not able to release this literature or this the message of Srimad Bhagavatam. So when we keep on hearing this message slowly every day, anudinam khalu seva jushta, then what happens that this same thing which appears, the same message which is appearing very distasteful in the beginning, or so this message then slowly starts acting upon us, and then gradually our conditioned state is purified. It is like when one is suffering from the disease of pitta, bile. Initially the sugar cane juice appears to be very bitter, but the medicine is that only, sugar cane juice. And when he keeps on drinking that sugar cane juice, gradually his disease subsides and the sugar cane juice starts tasting him slowly and slowly sweet, sweeter and sweeter. And one day, when he's finally all the disease has gone, he can able to release the sweet taste of the sugar cane juice. So similarly, we are in such conditioned state where we are not able to release this Srimad Bhagavatam. So the process is chanting and hearing. And this chanting and hearing, they are not actually separated. Here it is said that in this sloka, Syat Krishnadi Charitadi, the nectar of instruction verse. By hearing, and by hearing what we are reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, and that is chanting, that is kirtan. So this message, hearing and chanting, this, by hearing this, we are gradually purified. And how we should hear? Prabhupada is writing that submissive hearing. And this submissive hearing will only lead us to the desired goal. We should be very careful to hear from the right source. Yesterday, Dauji Prabhupada was discussing that about this Vedic literature, the fruit, that how in villages children used to pick up the fruit which has been fallen, especially from the mango tree, which fruit has been tested by the parrot. So the children will fight, or they will run to catch or to find the fruit which has been earlier bitten by parrot, because that fruit becomes more tasty than other fruits. And when some small children have, if someone has found that fruit, the bigger boys will come and exchange. They will try to exchange it with bigger fruits. Please give me your fruit, I will give you bigger fruit. Similar was the situation when Sukhdev Goswami started giving this Bhagavatam narration. The devta from Devlok, they came and they wanted to exchange this amrita with their own nectar. They thought, they asked, please give this nectar to Parikshit, he will be saved from his death and we will release Bhagavatam. Then Sukhdev Goswami said, ye baniya kahan se aa gaya? This is not a message which can be exchanged. And you are not a fit person, you don't know the value of Srimad Bhagavatam, and he drove them away. So they were not adhikari, they were not fit to hear in that place the message of Srimad Bhagavatam. So this Srimad Bhagavatam is coming from the lips of Sukhdev Goswami, Sukha Mukhad. So the process is, we have to hear it submissively. Bhagavad Gita 4.32, it is said that tad vidhi pranipatena pariprashnena sevaya upadekshanti te jnanam jnaninas tattva darshina. So by submissive inquiring from the spiritual master, then only this knowledge will be delivered. When one is inquiring from the spiritual master and serving him, then when the spiritual master is pleased, then this knowledge is imparted in the heart. Otherwise the information will be there, but not transformation. Once one devotee was distributing books in train, and he met some guys from other faith, and he was challenging. He was giving quotation from Vishopanishad that God is near, God is very far. So he was basically mentioning that he has no form, God has no form. So he explained another verse from same Vishopanishad, that you remove your effulgence and please show me your personal form. So he was not ready to accept. Then the devotee said, from whom you are studying, unless and until you are submissive and serving your spiritual master, you will not be able to receive this knowledge. And he showed this verse of Bhagavad Gita, which he was having the Bhagavad Gita. Then he showed tad vidhi pranipatena, and he asked, kisi ko serve kiya hai kya? Have you ever served anyone? If you have not served and humbly inquiring, it's just challenging, then you will not be able to receive this knowledge. Otherwise, the scriptures are there, the knowledge of the scriptures are there, but no transformation. It is like shikari aayega, dana dalega, jal bichhayega, lobh mein aakar fasna nahi, but the bird will get trapped. So that birds have remembered all the instructions, but that instruction was of no use. Why? Because they have just memorized it, they have not internalized it. Without internalizing, the message has no value. It is just information, and information are there in this world, they are floating in the air. You want to inquire anything, just type, ask Google Guru, he will give you knowledge. But whether Google Guru will able to transform you, serious question. Until you practice and do something, it's not possible. So it is a matter of heart, that whether you are ready to accept that message. And if it is coming from the right source, then only that information will lead to transformation. Otherwise, it will lead to deformation of consciousness, degradation of conformation, consciousness. And when the right source is not there, then this sukha mukhad can become sarpa mukhad. That it is milk which has been touched by the lips of snake. The same milk which is nectarian in nature, when it is touched by the lips of a snake, it becomes poisonous and it has a negative effect. When one drinks such milk, his death is sure. We have also heard that how this literature people discuss in their academics very nice. Like in one of the scholars, they were doing PhD in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu in Western universities. And when one devotee came to know that such a person is there who is doing PhD, let me go and discuss. I'm also interested in these subject matters and I also want to explore it more. But when he went to meet that person in his chamber, he saw that he was having Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu in his one hand and glass of beer in another hand. So it is just for information. They are not using it for transformation. They just want to accumulate more and more knowledge so that they can show them off to the world that how they are more learned. So these persons may analyze the scriptures just by criticizing or critically analyzing, but with that there will be no change because they are not having faith just for their economic advancement. So with such things, we will not be able to purify ourselves. We also see in our life that before coming to ISKCON, we have also heard the message of scriptures, especially Bhagavad Gita earlier. But that used to make almost no sense, that how it is applicable in my life. But when we come in the contact with devotees to the purport of Bhakti Vedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada, then it makes some sense. Then gradually coming in contact with devotees more and more, we try to apply this knowledge and slowly we change. Even if we feel that we have not changed, just look back 10 years back, 10, 20 years back, what we were doing at that time and what things we have left and what things we have accepted in this process of devotional service. Has it not changed our consciousness? Certainly it has made some impact in our heart. So this message which is presented in Bhagavad Gita, when it is delivered from the right source, then it makes sense. Otherwise, we see that there are many institutions who are following the Sanatana Dharma, but the message what the persons are delivering makes sometimes no sense or it has a negative effect. Why? Because most of the time the institution is known by the persons who are following it, not by the scriptures, not just by the scriptures what the institution is following. Because with the same scriptures, person can be very fanatic and with a very accommodating also. So when the person is able to inspire others to take up devotional service, that is like a thing which everyone likes. Otherwise, sometimes in the name of scriptures, we become fanatic. And it is not that I'm saying that we should water down our principles, but it should be always accommodating and always encouraging for others to take up this devotional service. And in their to help others to advance in their journey of back to Godhead. Every one of us as a practicing sadhaka has a responsibility to help others in their journey back home, back to Godhead. It is said in the scriptures that guru na sasyat, sojano na sasyat, pita na sasyat, janani na sasyat, daivam na tasyat, patish na sayat, na mochayet, samupayet mrityum. That one should not take the position of these things like guru, father, mother, demigods, unless and until he can deliver the dependents of him or the followers of him from the cycle of birth and death. But we see that most of the time who are around us, father, mother, or as a leader of the society, Every one of us is leader in some sense. So if you're not able to, we feel that we have to deliver the person just in this lifetime only. But it's not possible for most of the person to take up this devotional service so seriously that he can go back and back to Godhead in this one lifetime. So what is the other way? That at least encourage that person not to remain where he is. At least go above that position. So we have the responsibility to encourage the person who are following this process or who are even not following this process to take up this process of devotional service. So institutional reputation is by the teacher, and this is spiritual reputation of these scriptures is by bona fide disciplic succession. Examples and exemplary teachers, where the teachers are like Sukhdev Goswami, Narad Muni, Vyasdev, Sukhdev Goswami, all these are there, and who are always encouraging the sadhaka to take up this devotional service. And even sometime while criticizing, they are extending their helping hand to help this sadhaka to take up this devotional service. Even if he has left the devotional service or he has fallen down from his position, to take up this devotional service and go ahead. And this situation sometimes is absent in family, like if parents are there, or in a group of devotees, where it may happen that the top person is very famous, very successful, and his success story is so much narrated that the person who are on the lower rung, they feel that they are not of that much caliber, and they always in comparing mode, and they are not able to deliver their best. They try to imitate their peers, not knowing that what is the best in them and how to deliver that best out to the society. Everyone is having some hidden talents, hidden gifts, maybe not exactly to the person who is aspiring or seeing as his peers, but he is having unique gift given by Krishna based on his karma, based on his past life. So, and Krishna wants that thing to be purified and that thing to be served to him, offered to him. Otherwise, if we just keep on copying others and pasting it, Krishna is not going to please, because Krishna has given you something, your unique properties. And if you offer that thing to Krishna, then Krishna is very much pleased. So I was saying that sometimes parents are very much successful, and their success story, when the children hear and they are not able to perform in their life, they feel that they are of no use. One very big business tycoon is there. He was telling about his child that his child is not so much successful. And he was telling that under a big banyan tree, nothing grows. Why? Because the father has amassed so much wealth, he's so much famous in the whole world, that however that this child will try, he will not become like that. So he is always thinking that he's not able to perform. And he's always in the fear. He says that, give me some, I want to work with some salary in some other company. I don't want to work in this company. Because he has always that fear. Because he has not got his encouragement to perform whatever he can perform his best in his life. Similarly, in our devotional service, someone may be very good in delivering lectures, someone may be very good in taking care of other parts of aspects of devotional service. So we should find out that and try to engage that activity in Krishna consciousness. Try to make that offering to Krishna. By that, Krishna will be much more pleased than just imitating others. Because by imitating others, we will not be satisfied. And when we are not satisfied, we will not make others satisfied. So here, the exchange of mellows. Exchange of mellows happens between Lord and the devotees. In the purport is written, Sukadeva Goswami is liberated even in the womb of mother, and still he got attracted to Srimad Bhagavatam. He was liberated. He was not knowing the pastime of Lord. So when he came out from the womb of his mother, his father sent some person and they were reciting Srimad Bhagavatam. And Sukadeva Goswami, he was He was saying that he will not come home. He just, after taking birth, he went out from his home and father was running behind him. But then Vyasdev tried some trick and he sent some person to sing the glories of Bhagavatam. And when Sukadeva Goswami was hearing this Srimad Bhagavatam, he got attracted. So this Srimad Bhagavatam attracts even the person who are on the liberated stage, who are on the who has nothing to do with this material world, and who are having no knowledge of the personal pastimes of the Lord, they even got attracted. So Lord's pastimes are, here Prabhupada is writing that Lord's pastimes are more attractive to liberated souls than to mundane people. He is not impersonal because it is only possible to carry on rasa with a person. We cannot exchange mellows with a dead object. Dead objects' mellows are not releasable. It is just scintillating sensation for some time, like a new mobile is there. You may try to release it or enjoy it for few days, but after few days when the same mobile is ringing, someone else has to remind you your mobile is ringing. That attraction has faded away in just few days. So with material objects, material person, this may also happen when we are just relating with bodily concept of life. When it is related with higher principle based on a spiritual platform, and especially with Krishna, then these rasas are fully manifested and fully releasable. Otherwise, it is not releasable. With the impersonal form, no one can release any mellows, any rasa. Once one teacher asked a student that, can anyone give us the example of nothing? So what is the example of nothing? So one student said, yes, it's very easy. What is that? A bladeless knife without handle. So first, it is bladeless knife and without handle. Is there anything? Nothing. So similar is the situation with impersonalists. They describe God with neti, neti. He is not having nose, he is not having mouth, he is not having ears. Then what is? Nothing is there. Kuch nahi to hai kya? We have told that he is God, he is full of all appliances, everything is there. But you are now negating everything. You are removing each and every aspect of the God. He is not having eyes, he is not having mouth, he can't walk, he can't talk. So all these things are there, neti, neti. It is like bladeless knife without handle. With bladeless knife without handle, you can't cut any fruit, you can't eat it, and you can't release it. So there is no mellows. So to enjoy or to release a spiritual life, you need personal interaction. With impersonal feature, you cannot release Srimad Bhagavatam or with the Lord. That's why it is said that to release this mellow, God has to have this all transcendental qualities and with personal feature. In Srimad Bhagavatam, transcendental pastimes of Lord are narrated and systematically depicted by Sukadeva Goswami, accepting all classes of person, including those who seek liberation to release the humor of becoming one with the Supreme Whole. So the person who are desiring to become one with the Supreme Whole, they also get attracted to the personality of Godhead. Otherwise, the philosophy of impersonalism, which describes God as bladeless knife without handle, in itself is like a blade. When you associate with this blade, you get cut off. So that's why it is said that mayavad bhasya sunite hoite sarvanas. So when you are cooking in the kitchen, all the person must be having this experience. Sometime you got cut because you are dealing with knife. However you are cautious with fire, with knife, with me personally, if I am cutting, every day I will get some cut. And every day somewhere minor burn, something will be there, which is not noticeable, but that is there with me. Because I'm not so expert, but expert people also get some time. So associating with this impersonal features is like cutting ourselves. If one is not blessed or not blessed to inquire about these things, then he should be better refrain from such activities. Otherwise, it is said that chaku kharbuje pe gire ya kharbuja chaku pe, katna to kharbuje ko hai. So we will get cut, no one else. So that is the situation here. So that Prabhupada is writing that this Srimad Bhagavatam is releasable by the even the person who are in the liberated stage or who are having the humor of becoming one with the Supreme Whole. Hare Krishna. Srimad Bhagavatam ki. Any question or any comments? Srila Prabhupada ki.